Hello, Lakers Nation. It's game day. Lakers versus Denver Nuggets, game two. Can the Lakers even the series and get one on the road, take home court advantage away from Denver if they can get the win tonight? Come join us over on playback.tv/Lakers Nation for the game tonight. Man, this is going to be a massive, massive game. Joining me is Mark Gunnels from LakersNation.com. Mark, this is a huge, huge night. Lakers badly need to get this win, but not favored to do so. What are you expecting to see in this one tonight?
Yeah, so, I mean, first of all, with the line, it's not surprising to see Denver favored once again at home. They haven't lost a home game in these playoffs, just like the Lakers haven't lost at home in these playoffs as well. So, you know, it's going to take a valiant effort. I think what I'm looking for mostly is the first quarter. I think, obviously, you're probably going to see Rui start today. I know there's always rumblings about that. Chris Haynes had a report saying that Darvin Ham is considering that. I think that's the obvious play there. Not going with a three-guard lineup against this big team. Get some size in there. Obviously, you had the Rui matchup on Jokic with AD roaming. I like that idea. Go ahead and tack that again and see how that works out. And then, yeah, obviously, I think the effort. I mean, Jokic had 12 rebounds in the first quarter of that game one. So, I mean, that's good enough for – that's a great game for most players, let alone one quarter. So, I think if you can limit that, get out to a quicker start tonight, build some confidence, have some – get some doubt in that home crowd, right? Because, you know, when you get out to a quick start, they're running in transition, they're going, the crowd's involved, the altitude plays a factor early on. It's kind of hard to play uphill from that point. But if you take away that first quarter, if you look at every quarter after that, the Lakers played them pretty even for the most part. It was just that first quarter that was the difference.
Yeah, and the first quarter certainly was rough. And ultimately, when you look at the final score, that you could say that's essentially where they lost the game, when Lakers could not do anything on the glass. Seemed like every time Denver missed, they were getting an offensive rebound. So it didn't really matter. Lakers couldn't get stops in the first quarter. So they're going to have to clean that up. Maybe it is a Rui Hachimura insertion into the starting lineup that fixes it. Is this a must win for the Lakers, or how are you looking at this?
Must win. I'm not going to say it's a must win. I do think, obviously, it's a win that you really, really want to get. Yeah. But considering that the Nuggets haven't lost at home in these playoffs, the Lakers have been lost at home in these playoffs. If you go based on that, even if you're down 0-2, theoretically, you could come back to Denver game five tied 2-2 if you can protect home court. Now, obviously, the pressure would be on, because then at that point, you really can't lose one game at home, because you go down 3-1, it's pretty much over at that point. So I'm not going to say must win, but it's probably the closest thing you can to say it's a must win.
I think if you lose game two, game three becomes a definite must win. But this is as close as you can get to it, because, again, you need to get one on the road, shift home court back to L.A., and the Lakers didn't get it done in game one, almost did, almost came back and got in that thing. But now they've got to find a way to get it done in this one. Otherwise, I think you're right, game three and game four become absolute must wins if the Lakers lose these first two games. So ideally, you find a way to get it done tonight in Denver, game two, go out there, get the win, come back to LA with the series tied and the Lakers having home court advantage. That's what you want to see tonight from the purple and gold. You know, Mark, whenever we have you come on, we take a look at the betting lines. You mentioned it already. The Nuggets are a 5.5-point favorite currently to win this game, which is pretty substantial, especially considering how close last game got. So what are you thinking on that line? And are there any other player props or anything that you're taking a look at?
Yeah, so I'm feeling pretty good today. So I'm actually going to take Lakers money line plus money at plus 175. Now, if you're not that confident, maybe just go with the spread and take the 5.5, which I feel really, really good about. But I really, truly believe Lakers come in and have that better start in the first quarter. And I think that's really going to be key to set the tone early. So I do like the Lakers to even this series up 1-1. Heading back out here to LA. And then as far as player props goes, I'm looking at LeBron James, his points at 25.5. I think he starts the game a lot quicker as far as being more aggressive early on. He knows that this is a game that you really, really want to get to even it up at 1-1. If you get down 0-2, that's a very daunting task, even though you are coming back home. But against this Denver Nuggets team, you don't want to get in a 2-0 hole. So I expect to see a lot more aggressive LeBron hunting Jamal Murray on those screens. I think you see a lot of that again tonight, getting the matchup that he wants and getting downhill. Because even last game, I know people are talking about that last three, and I understand that. But he only shot three threes in that game. And we've seen a lot of games from LeBron where he shoots 7, 8, 9 threes sometimes in the game. So he only shot three threes, and I think he's going to have a similar mindset, but maybe a little bit more attacking instead of deferring to others, which I think he'll do a good mix of both. But I still like him to get at least 26 points tonight in a close to a must-win game in Denver.
Yeah, he actually, according to ESPN, he took 4 threes. I think they updated that after the last game. At one point, it was showing 3, and then they changed it to 4. But the bottom line is, you're right. I think he did a nice job getting to the rim last game and sort of forcing the issue, because that's what the Lakers need to do. This Denver team, their weakness or one of their weaknesses, it's their rim protection, and the Lakers need to live at the basket on the offensive end. I thought LeBron James did a nice job of that in game one. So can he keep that going and then get over that point total? I think the answer is yes. I think he's going to be fully pushing down on the gas pedal. Same thing with AD, same thing with the entire Lakers team. They don't want to go down 0-2. I think we're going to see the Lakers at their best effort in this one tonight, but we'll see if that's enough to get it done. Look, Denver, very clear. They're a very good team. They're a very good team. I think both these teams are incredibly talented, and I think we're in for a very close series, but the Lakers got to find a way to be ahead when that final buzzer sounds tonight. Lakers Nation, give us your thoughts in the comments down below. Can the Lakers get game two in Denver? How confident are you that they're going to get it done despite Vegas saying that the Nuggets are a 5.5-point favorite to win this game? Again, give us your thoughts in the comments section. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, stay safe and see you.